I don't know if anyone else is extremely nervous. I bet there are some that are quite nervous at this time, having severe, last week, just severe nervous problems. Very tough to dampen them down right now. Maybe it has something to do with the fate of the world up in the air as far as conflict, and or it could have to do with the comet coming in, causing effects at a distance, going past Mars. There could be some interactions with Mars in some way, so I don't know, but we're going to put all those aside, because what we're looking for here is for the breakthrough. And that is what I am working on. I'm not working on just the same old stuff you see on YouTube about blah, 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 oh, doom, 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 doom. No, I'm saying we want the remedy for doom. We want a breakthrough, a breakthrough. So today there was a breakthrough. There's still at least one more to go, maybe more than one, but this was a huge breakthrough. So let me share that with you in this video. How to get into this. What I found out, let me see. To put it in the simplest terms, there's a part of our mind where everything is easy, and there's a part of our mind, area of our mind, where everything is what we call difficult. Now here's the secret about the situation that the Holy Spirit shared with me today, and it was just like bingo. There's a part of our mind that is concerned with what is not difficult but impossible, and yet we define it as difficult. So we're in this area of the mind that is concerned with difficulty, and our lives are difficult, everything's difficult. But I tell you this for sure, there's an area of your mind where everything is easy. So the correct mantra is, it's either easy or it's impossible. It's either easy or it's impossible. This is a profound truth. And I, using it during the day, I suddenly became aware that we can literally turn our attention away from the difficult, quote unquote, to the easy. From the impossible to the easy. From the impossible to easy. So it's either easy or it's impossible. Now it takes some context of explanation here, but if you can get this, it's either easy or it's impossible. It rang a bell for me, a huge bell. I've been trying to figure out, how do we turn our attention to the enlightened part of us, at the area in our mind which is free of difficulty, which is blissful? And I said, because you realize that the area of the mind that we call difficulty, which is engaged in human effort, and all everything that we're doing as humans here, it's not difficult, it's impossible. It's impossible. And we are misdefining our endeavors as difficult. As soon as you define them as impossible, suddenly your attention feels like it can move over to the area where it's all easy. What is easy? I'll tell you what's easy. Truth is easy. Enlightenment is easy. Truth is, facts are very easy. Incredibly easy. Effortlessly easy. As a matter of fact, they're effortless. So you might say it's either effortless or it's impossible. But I call it easy or impossible. So I finally felt my attention being able to start pivoting a little bit away from the difficult, which is really impossible, back to the easy. Now, when we do this, we think we're regressing to childhood. Why? Because when we were young, we're still in that area of the mind which it's all easy. I remember, just for me, facts were just easy. I just knew everything. I was operating in the part of the mind that just knows. And then gradually the world says, you know, you're supposed to make it difficult. You're supposed to get into the area where it's difficult, because we have difficult work to do. And You know, your attitude is all too easy, so it's not right. You're not doing your share. You need to be in a perplexed, difficult, struggling state of mind. And so that's what happened. I turned my attention into the realm of the impossible. Because what we're trying to do in existence is literally learn how to die spiritually. Can't be done. So we are defining existence as we're struggling with something that's very difficult. Nobody's quite sure what the difficulty is exactly. They're not. If you look at people and you try to pin them down and do they really know what's going on with life and existence and everything, they don't know. They really don't know. They just, you reach a state of just confusion, and they try to throw you off track because they don't want to admit that they don't really know, or they're not aware. It's impossibility. But it's impossibility disguised. And so we keep struggling. We say, I can't quite get it. You know, just too difficult. It's a little too difficult for me. It's not a little too difficult, it's impossible. So again, we start turning our attention towards the easy area of the mind that is engaged with easiness, which means it's engaged with facts, with truth, with the Holy Spirit, with the Holy Spirit's dream, solves a continuity problem, all of that. And we say, oh my gosh, I'm going back to childhood, I'm regressing. I remember how I used to feel this way. It's too simple. You know, I want to be an adult, I want to be mature, I want to be tackling tough issues and all this kind of stuff. So there's enormous a current that is pushing you away from your attention away from there. It's like going into a wind, like a powerful, powerful wind that you're, you know, fighting against, trying to move your attention there. But you're not regressing at all. You're simply moving your attention back to the area of the mind that is occupied, concerned, or aware of what is easy, what is easy. And for instance, you can tell if people are bluffing or not from there, or lying or not, or trying to deceive you or not, or off track or not. It's easy. It's actually easy to be a guru, very easy. The gurus are simply the ones who have accepted this area of the mind where it's all easy. Piece of cake, easy. It's not difficult, because it's either easy or it's impossible. So you literally have to function from the standpoint of this ease, this easiness. Jesus said you need to become like little children. What is he talking about? He's talking about this area of the mind that is engaged with easiness. When we were little children, there was still we weren't, we have not gone, you know, into the difficult area, into difficulty, into impossibility. So what he means is, get back to that sense of knowing, easy. You just obvious, completely obvious. The whole thing, it's a piece of cake. And it's like, wow, no difficulty at all. Literally, there's no difficulty with truth. Truth is not difficult. Facts are not difficult. Knowing is not difficult. Recognition is not difficult. None of this stuff is difficult. It's completely easy. It's the impossible that is difficult. It's more than difficult. But we, of course, refuse to admit that it's impossible. So the root of our trouble is denial. Now, here's another breakthrough that I had today. When you talk to people, the attitude of the world is Spirit wants to be prime creator, wants to be God, so it's trying to act like God. Now, Spirit knows that God has no doubt whatsoever. There's no such thing as a doubt or anything in reality. So Spirit is trying to mimic this and claims it has no doubt that existence is right and what it's doing is right, and it doesn't question at all the difficulty of it, all of it. There's no doubt that this is going to work. It's simply trying to imitate God, pretend that it is God, say, oh, I don't have any doubts at all. That. But I want to tell you this. What it doesn't have any doubt about is doubt. Spirit is doubting that God is seamless and cannot be fractured or cannot be flawed or cannot be undone or something. Spirit says, I'm sure that somewhere, somehow, there's a chink in God's armor, so to speak, and we're going to find it. So in other words, Spirit is doubting reality. That reality is eternal and invulnerable and cannot be fragmented. It doubts that. And so when it says it has no doubt, what it means, what it's really saying, is it has no doubt in doubt. And that's not God, is it? Because God doesn't have any doubt. Spirit's the one that has doubt. So it's really doubting. This all of existence is really doubt. Denial, doubt. And we're just really insisting that doubt is, we don't doubt doubt. We don't doubt doubt. So the ego gets into level confusion like here, and we cannot see this situation because it's very odd, isn't it? We don't doubt doubt and therefore think that we're not doubting. See, that is a logical fallacy. We are doubting. When we don't doubt doubt, we're doubting. And I saw that today very easily. So it's the part of our mind that's engaged with ease, easy, that can see all this stuff. I mean, when I can tune into that part, it's just like all this wisdom comes. It's so easy and beautiful stuff. I love to hear that part of the mind just say something, talk and its perspective. But here's another thing. You can't take what is totally easy into what is impossible. You cannot. That's impossible. It won't work. Because it won't be experienced as easy. It'll be experienced as difficult. So when you hear the guru say something very, you know, just perfect, you say, ah, that's great. Okay, now, how do we bring this into difficulty? How do we help difficulty out? You cannot help difficulty out. It's like saying, how do we nurture a lie and turn it into truth? You cannot. I tell you this, that lies have to be abandoned. Impossibility has to be abandoned. My position is one of abandonment. We must, the whole purpose of this is to recognize we must set it down. We must abandon lies for truth. We cannot bring lies into truth. We cannot nurture lies to become true. That's impossible. And yet that's what we're trying to do. We're all trying to be mothers to a lie and raise up the lie and make it true. Not possible. That's where we experience the difficulty. We're thinking, wow, we're having such a hard time raising something up. We're trying to nurture, trying to nurture, trying to nurture, and it's so difficult, so difficult. And we want help. You know, we come into the world, we're in the right state of mind of everything's easy with facts, and the world says, hey, and we need help here. We're working so hard to nurture something here, and you got to help us out and take some responsibility, load upon your shoulders. And then you go into the difficult part of the mind, which is really impossible, area that's engaged with impossibility, and you suffer like crazy. You cannot nurture and raise a lie up to be true. You cannot nurture and raise up no doubt about doubt and have it equal no doubt. It is no doubt about doubt, and that is doubt. It's insanity. You cannot nurture insanity and make it true. And make it sanity. You cannot. And that is what the world's engaged with. And so it keeps telling you you're supposed to leave the area of your mind that's occupied with what's easy and obvious and true over to what's completely confused, insane, and impossible and difficult. That's what the world tells you you're supposed to do to be a responsible citizen, responsible person here in this world. Again, complete madness. And yet, the pressure is so extreme, we all do that. to a greater or lesser extent. I resisted it severely, but I still did it. And then I tried to say, well, I'll tell you what, I'll fix whatever difficulty you have. I'll just work on it like crazy so I can get back to the easy. And then I realized, you can't fix what's impossible. You can't fix it. So we have to give up thinking we're these great mothers, these great nurturers. We're not. We are not. We're not raising or nurturing anything. The impossible cannot be nurtured. It's meaningless to say such a thing. Meaningless. So, there you had another breakthrough. So just a series of breakthroughs here today, which is central to shifting our attention. What I'm trying to convey, or what that area of the mind that is occupied with easiness, which is trying to convey this to me, to share, is that we need to turn our attention to that area of the mind that's occupied with easiness, with bliss. We need to turn our attention. It's a matter of attention. It's right, it's there, but we don't turn our attention because we think we need to be responsible and help nurture this mysterious something. Nobody's quite sure what we're nurturing. Everybody's working on it, earnestly working on it. And they see the guru and they say, irresponsible. Irresponsible. They're laughing. Everything's so easy. They say, they're not taking on any responsibility, really. I'll tell you this. It's your responsibility to turn your attention to facts, which is easy. Facts are easy. That is everyone's responsibility. So the guru is fulfilling the one responsibility we all have. And the others are avoiding it. They're still having no doubts about doubt. Still chasing the end of the rainbow, trying to be prime creator. Still suffering from fear of the continuity problem. All this stuff. And yet they all are agreeing that no, they're doing an incredible nurturing job. You know, and they'll just invent all sorts of nurturing stories. We're nurturing this, we're nurturing that, we're nurturing... Endless nurturing stories, right? Everyone's always trying to help nurture something. But the one thing that nobody does, with rare exception, is to turn the attention to facts, to what is easy. And whenever I get close, it's like beautiful, quote-unquote, music. I mean, the clarity is better than any song, better than any music or song. That is for sure. It's like, wow, I love to hear from that aspect. I say, come on, don't be a stranger. I mean, but you can't bring it in to difficulty. It gets lost. That's the air that everyone makes. They think, okay, I'm going to listen to truth, and I'm going to then bring it in back to difficulty and help me resolve this difficulty. No, you've got to abandon the impossible. You've got to turn away from it. This is what we're trying to do right now. I'm not predicting whether success or failure in this. I'm just saying this is what we are trying to do. This is what we're called to do. This is what we're attracted to do. And it's a good time to do it because our nerves are getting worked over right now. Really worked over. Obviously, there's something that is very much troublesome coming up. I remember before 9/11, I had the same nervous problems for about a month before 9/11. And I couldn't get rid of it. No matter what I did, I kept thinking, there's something wrong with me. What's wrong with me? I couldn't get rid of it. It was terrible, terrible, terrible. And then in the morning of 9/11, I was someplace in a beautiful park, beautiful setting. And I came home and I heard that something had happened. And I immediately realized, oh my gosh, that's what I was worried about. That's what I was shown to dream 3 years prior to. All of this exactly what was indicated. And then, you know, the fear dissipated, you know. So I thought it was going to be an attack on me or something. I didn't know. I knew there was an attack, some terrible pivoting of events in the world history is going to happen. It was this crushing dread. It was just awful. So right now, there's this enormous, you know, anxiety, like, wow, jumping out of our skin. It's something maybe people are not looking at. There's a lot more going on than meets the eye. But anyway, it produces a lot of anxiety and nervousness, and we think it's just something about our own psyche or something. Well, the area of difficulty is something that's shared with everybody. That area of the mind, we're all tuned into it, and it's kind of like we're all watching the same TV shows, you know, and so. It's like a collective sort of thing, but we turn our attention to what's easy. There's no more sense of nervousness or anxiety or anything like that, because you're simply dealing with falsity is very easy from there. Very easy. And you know what to say. Easy. You know what to say. You know how to handle it. And every situation is easy. It is easy. And I've seen it, how to do it, but I keep trying to function in the difficult area, and it's not possible. You cannot do it. You either function easily or you function with difficulty. There isn't any option. You have to choose one or the other. And functioning with difficulty right now is becoming too difficult. Really, it is, which is a good thing. It's becoming way, way, way too difficult. In order to cross the Golden Gate Bridge now, you have to use Fast Track, or you have to have an account. You have to have this sort of online account, or it's becoming very high tech. No cash, you're out of luck, no cash. So what do you do if you're an older person, you're not hip, or if you're just a person that you don't like all this technology, which is a very wise thing, actually. I can't see how people really do like it at all. Very bad stuff, really. Yeah, but they're blinded. They're blinded because it seems to be helping them with their difficulty. Right? No. It's just perpetuating the illusion that they're dealing with difficulty. They're not dealing with difficulty. They're dealing with impossibility. Okay, this is something that I know. Because entertaining mutual exclusives, which is the ego, the ultimate aim of all this, how spirit can die, is entertain mutual exclusives. And this should bring about a death and a resurrection, as it were. It doesn't. It just brings about a sense of inner chaos and disorientation. A spirit cannot die, but it can have this horrible experience. So, the goal that the ego, a goal of being prime creator, is impossible. So, but what we do is we keep trying to deceive ourselves and thinking that we're engaged with difficulty. So all this technology is designed to make us feel like, keep reinforcing that we are just dealing with something difficult, not impossible, just difficult. And you say, see, look at all this technology. It's not impossible. Look what we got, these new gadgets. Every time we start thinking, I think, maybe we're dealing with impossibility. Some wizard comes along and says, ah, look at this, look what I have for you. And now, see, doesn't that make it a little easier for you? So it's just merely difficult now, it's not impossible, right? Right, and that's what they're teaching in school now. It's terrible to be a child at this time. Terribly difficult. Imagine rejecting all this technology, saying it's all a delusion. You're just trying to enhance the mirage of difficulty, which blinds us to the impossibility. I'm sure there are young people out there that see through this. They have the capacity, but wow, most do not. That's a tough one, because it's so ubiquitous now. It's just everywhere. There's raised your homework, everything is what if you say, no, I don't want to do that? Oh my gosh, they probably think you're mentally ill. I mean, if I was raised in this generation, like I was like in school now, they would definitely say that I have a very bad mental illness or something, and be looking for drugs, etc., 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 because I would refuse to do that stuff. I say, no, I'm not doing any of that stuff. And, you know, they just say, you're an obstinate, you're an obstructionist, you must have some kind of mental illness, there's attention deficit, there's something wrong, we'll find out. I say, don't worry, we'll find out what's wrong with you and fix it. I say, well, no, there's nothing wrong with me. I'm just functioning from the area that's occupied with what is facts and what is easy. It's what's wrong is with you. And of course, their arrogance and pride won't allow them to even entertain that as a remote possibility. So I had a difficult enough time coming into the world when I did, but now, I mean, good Lord, people didn't say I was mentally ill or anything. They just said, you're very stubborn, very obstinate and stubborn. How come you don't agree with us? Obviously you're wrong and you refuse to admit you're wrong. And it's terrible, but it was, nowadays they would absolutely have all sorts of treatment modalities for you. Could use special teachers and, you know, oh boy. The teachers just got frustrated with me, really frustrated, but they just kind of said, oh well, you know, I'm not gonna worry about him too much. So it's getting tougher and tougher in my opinion. But I'm sure there's somewhere there are some young people who know that area of the mind of ease, it's all easy. It's all easy. You don't need any technology to be easy. That it's all easy. Facts are self-evident. Facts are self-evident. There's a knowing. It's just a knowing. Effortless knowing. What's different? Nothing difficult about facts. What's difficult is to attempt the impossible. Because there's no facts there at all. You have to keep making everything up. That's super difficult. People don't realize how difficult it is. And once you vet the whole thing, then you say, oh my God, it's impossible. And we're just deluding ourselves. Level confusion is very prevalent in the whole situation that keeps you bound and doubting. No doubts about doubt, for instance, an example of level confusion. There are other examples. One of them came up today. And the part of your mind that is engaged with what is easy sees level confusion easily. Here you are, you're struggling and say, wow, it's so difficult. It's easy. Easy, 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 easy. Completely obvious. I remember I used to be able to see people's minds, how they worked and everything. I just, no, it's easy. Don't worry, guys. You're just making these, you know, silly mistakes. It's able to see the patterns that they're stuck in and all that. It's easy to do that. It's not an accomplishment. It's easy. See, difficulty wants an accomplishment. It wants a path. It wants to be able to accomplish something. It wants to say, okay, how did I go from the difficult to the easy? What was the process? You know, where's the stones? How did I lay the stones, the pathway? There is none. There is none. You don't progress from the difficult to the easy. In other words, you don't make difficulty easy. You never do. You never do. You never do. You abandon difficulty. You turn your back on it. That's not a process. Difficulty is looking for the progress. How did difficulty progress to easy? And of course, people are trumpeting, technology is how you do it. You never do it. You abandon it. You abandon the impossible for the easy. So abandon the impossible for the easy. Realize we can turn our attention and turn our back. It's an inner mental attention. We simply turn our attention to the area of the mind that is engaged with facts. Is it possible? I believe it is, because there are those who have done it. And they tell us, yes, you can. Absolutely, you can do it. But you know, who knows when you're finally going to make that pivot. But we're at a pivotal time in history. You know, we're time sensitive in that events affect us because we're in this difficult state of mind. And so all this stuff that's going on is like making us feel, you know, engage with the difficulty, engage that we feel like what is. We got to really buckle down to what is difficult. That's so. It's a very tough time, important time, if you don't want to get sucked down into just this incredible preoccupation with the impossible, really. And so it's super important to pivot at this time away from the impossible to the easy. And, you know, I say we need help because it's stigmatized, it's demonized. People say you're irresponsible, you must be on drugs, what's matter with you? How come you're not, you know, just all this negativity about you're not part of the solution, you a cop out. You know, there's just, it's the ego just throws all sorts of jeers and mockery and stuff like that at that. But it's not difficult for you. See, that's the thing, it is not difficult. Just dismiss it like that. Not even concerned about it. Because you know, you're able to see directly what their problems are. It's a continuity problem. You're able to see, and it's just, you just function effortlessly, even in the midst of all that jeering. But from the standpoint of difficulty, that seems like impossible. How in the world is that possible? From the standpoint of, it's not from the standpoint of difficulty, it's from, but from the standpoint of ease, it's easy. So we're going to try to do this, for sure we're going to try to do this. September is the pivotal month. Let's put it that way. September is the pivotal month. It's pivotal in the world, isn't it? Yeah, it's pivotal in the world. For sure, I'm not going to lay out any, try to stay away from dates. It tends to tighten people up. But it is, September is the pivotal month now. And we can pivot, and we're going to try to do so. And with the grace of the Holy Spirit, perhaps some of us will succeed. All right, very great. Let's keep our effort going on in this direction. That's it.